We are blind to our obsessions, and our obsession is consumption. Relentless consumption. You see, we need to have the next best phone. And then to go with that phone, we need a new watch. We need the best glasses. And then we need a new bag to put all of our stuff in. And then, of course, we need streaming music. And we need streaming TV and streaming movies and streaming news and streaming opinion and streaming and streaming lies and lies and lies swimming in our heads. And we consume without purpose. And we consume without reason. And we consume without regard for one another.
Tells us to have faith. But what does that even mean?
Something just touched me.
Think about your life. Where you are, what you've done. Does it give you purpose? Do you feel fulfilled? Or do you feel lost? Adrift in a sea of uncertainty?
Thank you.
about freeing up the Hot Spring Hotel, Rook. We'll be able to use that old building as a place of shelter, even though most folks around here would think twice. You know, some say that place is haunted. But I never much bought into that kind
just
of argument.
Just when you think things can't get worse.
Anyway, keep up your good work, Rook.
You did a damn fine job getting rid of those cultists. Maybe you can help me with something else, too. You're not gonna believe me? There's a crazy-ass bear in Lydia's cave. The cult used that drug to try and turn it into some kind of weaponized super bear. Didn't work. And it got loose. It's nasty as all get out and tough. We sent a bunch of people to kill it, but none of them came back. I'm hoping you got what it takes to get rid of that sucker. Please, before it kills more people.
Team just reported in a cult priestess is spotted heading your way. Can't be a coincidence. You only have a few minutes to secure that area. Move carefully in there. They probably have hostages.
Understood! No baptism, no mercy!
picture. The Misery's days are numbered. One less place for Eden's Gate to terrorize these poor people. Good work, Rook. Let me be the first to thank you, Rook. You managed to track down all our missing persons. I'm gonna have to stop calling you Rookie. It's no small deed. Outstanding job, Deputy.
Thank you.
me once, shame on you. Fool me twice.
Come here, hotshot. I need your help. Adelaide Drubman, pleased to make your acquaintance. Appreciate all your help getting my marina back, but honey, I got a problem. Those Peggy shipbirds stole my tulip. She's the nimblest goddamn helicopter this side of Montana, and I'll be goddamned if those fuck trumpets are gonna take her from me. I won that bird in my divorce fair and square. The walking erectile dysfunction who took her painted her that awful shade of Peggy mayonnaise, so the only way you'll be able to find her is to ID the pilot. Should be easy to spot him. The only other birds around the area are flown by women. We all used to fly together on weekends, but that friendship went tits up after those thunder cunts joined Eden's Gate. So I got no problem if you accidentally shoot them in their disloyal faces. How about it, honey? You help me, and Tulip and I'll show up wherever and whenever you need us.
Being a member isn't always political. Sometimes it's just good to know you can survive without other people's help.
I've got a job for any fisherman who got time. There's this giant albino fish that swims around the marina. Locals call him Ragnar the Terrible. People have been trying to catch old Ragnar for ages, but he's damn stubborn. He likes to hang out by that little island over yonder. It'd be good for morale if someone finally caught him. I think you might have what it takes.
Hey, you there? It's Skylar. If you think you're ready to catch the Admiral, I'm down at the Claggett Boathouse. Got everything ready for us. Just waiting on you.
take a breather.
All right, man, I'm in and clench it onto the seat. Let's do this.
This place. I don't think you're seeing what I'm seeing. We're winning. I think.
That's what she said. Oh, that's a bad joke. Sounded funnier in my head.
Look out!
Don't feel too bad about shooting.
I've never felt so helpless. I've lost so many people, and I couldn't protect everyone I care about. That's what war does to you.
Visuals on target.
The only way out of this is to take her. She's gotta go.
You're back. Any luck?
I can't tell you how glad I am you found the McKellens. My dad swore it was a myth, but I knew better. That stuff's been aging underwater for more than half a century. Bet I could get a pretty penny for it. And maybe I will. But right now, I'm just enjoying this little family reunion. Thanks for everything.
The only way to get Faith's victims back is to go into the Bliss. But then you'll be in Faith's grip.
The only ones who will survive the collapse.
just remember, don't actually feed him cheeseburgers, because, you know, he's got the diabetes.
Get over here. So, you're the one that's been putting those bad hombres down. I thought you'd be taller. You a registered voter? Nah, don't matter. I need help of a different sort. Let's get to the point. You see that steaming pile of disappointment over there praying? That's my loin fruit, Hurt Jr. Dumber than a coal bucket. He takes after his mama. Stupid sumbitch went and lost my campaign truck, Nancy. So named after the greatest first lady to ever serve this fine country, of course. If them Obama-loving libtards find out I can't look after my own property, I can kiss this Senate run goodbye. Now, seeing as you're on my land, and I didn't kill you, even though it's well within my rights as a red-blooded American gun owner, I say you owe me. Help numbnuts get my truck back so I can start focusing on my campaign again. Junior, someone's here to help you. Try not to fuck it up.
I wrestled a bear buck naked once. I was gonna do it fully clothed, but I was like, if the bear's naked, I'll be naked. Even playing field. That's what I'm all about, man. Hey, man. I'm sorry. I don't want to go on assuming nobody's gender or nothing. I mean, I don't mean no disrespect. I just call all my homies dude or bro or man, you know, regardless of vagitalia or penile-ness. Whoa, deja voodoo, man. Have we met before? Dang, man, my prayers have been answered. I got a direct line to that sweet little monkey god whose heart hangs in heaven. Well, I guess since you're an angel working here on Earth, the Monkey King, that you already know I gotta get my daddy's truck back. I mean, he's real butt sore. But if we get it back, he'll let me sleep in my bed again. And I gotta tell you, man, it's getting real cold outside. Never mind them wood ticks crawling all up in my junk, threatening me with Lyme disease and whatnot. So come on, man, help me get my daddy's truck back. Let's make dust before the old man starts shooting. He's hotter than a ghost pepper these days. Senate run's been real stressful on him, man. He ain't cut out for that shit. You know how busy he is? He doesn't even have time to cut out for a shit. Come on, man, get in.
They'll have bombs and they'll have tanks, cause they've got money in their banks.
Shit, man, I've been praying on this all day, man. I've been asking the Monkey King, all the baby Jesuses, even the Bill of Valentine's one, just to send me a sign, man. They sent me here. Tell you something though, man, getting that truck, it ain't gonna be easy. Damn, cult's got it, man. Well, I'll be honest with you, it all started when I tried to join them. I mean, it just seemed like a good idea. I mean, they had all these guns, food, fine-ass females, and I mean, those are three things I'm really all about. I mean, it seemed like one big party over there, you know? So I says, hey, Migos, where do I sign up? He said, sign up right here, friend. Then they start listing off all their dang rules, man. No fornicating. Turns out that means fucking. No alcohol and no wilding out and partying, man. No thank you. So I got the fuck out of there, man. Unfortunately, though, I forgot my daddy's truck. He's been real butt sore since, so I gotta get that truck. Hey, you don't gotta worry about a thing, man. I got a 9-step plan to get in this truck, man. Step one, catch a day buzz off party liquor. Got that one covered, homie. Step two, pray for someone else to solve my problem. Done. Step three is... I forget the rest, but he'll come to me as soon as we go. Dang, you are a good listener, Boba Fett. My old man doesn't listen at all. Guess that's why I never feel heard. Me and him, we ain't getting along that well lately. Ever since he started running for office, he's been coming down on me real hard about everything. About my public intoxication, how I handle my firearms, stuff like that. When we get his truck back from them Peggy's, you're gonna be real impressed, dude. He's gonna love me so much, and then my mom's gonna have to try and love me more so she can compete with how much he loves me, and then he'll see how much she's loving me, and then he'll try and love me even more, and then birthdays and Christmases, they're gonna be off the chain. All right, man, this is the place. Jacob, still got your buddy Pratt, man. And if war movies have taught me anything, it's that you never leave a buddy outside. Or a guy behind. What came first, the chicken or the egg? Wait, what are we talking about, man? Were we gonna shoot something, or? Okay, man, now it's time for step four. Truck's actually all the way down yonder. Probably more Peggy's waiting for us, too. It's all about the zipline, man. We gonna zipline in there, sneak up on them like ninjas. Fuck yeah, man!
Oh, shit, stealth mode, right? Fuck yeah, man!
Dude, you should hang out with my little cousin Sharky while you're in town. You met him yet, man? He is fucking good people. Yeah, his parents weren't around so much, so I basically raised him, man. He's kind of like my son in a way. I did a kick-ass job, too, man. He rocks it hard. Real into shooting guns, explosions, and slamming beers, and clams. Oh, man, second coolest dude in Hope County, probably. You'd like him. Bear babies, I gotta have one. I just smoked the last of my catnip, otherwise I'd have given it to her. Does she like weed? I got some weed. Eat rockets, you jerkwads! Amigo. Okay, step five, let's move before more show up.
Watch out, bear!
Oh, man, we got trouble. Reach into that there cooler. See if we have any cans of whoop ass left. And pass me a beer, if there's any.
I'm thinking while you were gone. This whole Senate run is too much for me to handle on my own. I'm in need of a campaign manager, and you're just the kind of go-getter I need to get my ass in office. First task I've got is to take Junior with you wherever you go, so I don't have to hear him praying to that goddamn Monkey King no more. Second task is, let me think on it a bit. I'll get back to you.
Real nice pussy you got there.
Thank you. One of you will be strong.
Not again.
Get out of here, peaches.
I know you're in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, huh? You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take it. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. And all she had in the world was me. A nobody from nowhere with nothing. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head, and I leaned in and I could smell. And we prayed together, prayed for wisdom, prayed for strength. God's plan for me. I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped to her angelic face, and I pinched it shut. And after a little while, her legs began to kick and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh. Pain, sacrifice, these are all part of His test. And we have to prove that we can serve God no matter what He asks.
The herd. Keep moving.
Train! Cart! Kill!
sacrifice!
The weak.
Know your purpose!
Watch your time.
If you get the chance. We got a lot of work to do.